we are going to find dy dx and d2y dx too. For this parametric equation, we have x is equal to e to the t, and y is equal to t times e to the negative t. So we begin by doing the dy dx first. And because we are given parametric equation, to do this, we have to do dy dt and then divide it by dx dt. For the top, dy dt, we have to look at the y equation and do the derivative. This is t times e to the negative t, so we have to use the product rule. And the product rule says we have to first keep the first function, which is t, and then we multiply by the derivative of the second. Derivative of e to the negative t, it first repeats e to the negative t, but the chain rule says we have to multiply by the derivative of negative t, which is negative 1. So let's multiply by negative 1 right there. And then we add it with, we keep the second function, which is e to the negative t, and we multiply by the derivative of the first. So we multiply by derivative of t is 1, just like this. This is dy dt. And then we are going to divide this by dx dt. Well, we look at the x equation, the derivative of e to the t, it happens to be the same, just e to the t. So let me put down e to the t. But be sure, and let me indicate this right here for you guys. Be sure you really have to differentiate whichever the x equation is. And we just happen to get e to the t, which is the same as the original. That's the beauty of e to the something, right? E to the t. Anyways, I'm going to take some time to write this down better so that it will be easier for us to find d to y dx2. Let's see what we can do. For the first part, we have t times e to the negative t times negative 1. Whenever we have negative exponent, let's bring that down to the denominator. For this right here, let me put it down as negative t. And then for e to the negative t, I will write that down as over e to the positive t. And then we continue, we add it with, this is just e to the negative t, and then I can write that as 1 over e to the t. And then all this is all over the denominator, which is e to the t. And depends on how you want to simplify this complex fraction, I would just like to show you by multiplying the top and bottom by e to the t because of this. Okay. As you can see, when you do e to the t times this and that, this and that pretty much just cancel. On the top, you just have negative t plus 1. And let me put that down as 1 minus t. And on the bottom, we have e to the t times e to the t. That's e to the 2t. Phew, this is the first derivative in the way of the dy dx. Okay? And now let's go to d2y dx2, which represents the concavity to this parametric curve. For d2y dx2, we have to do the dt of the first derivative, dy dx, and then we divide it by dx dt. So what does this mean? This is dy dx, and then we are going to take the derivative of this with respect to time again. That means I have to look at this, and then do the derivative. 1 minus t over e to the 2t is a quotient, so the derivative of this, we have to use the quotient rule. Let me focus on that. And let me put it down right here. The quotient rule says I'm going to first square the denominator, which I'll put down. This is the denominator, e to the 2t, and then we square that. And then I am going to keep the denominator function, which is e to the 2t, right? And we multiply by the derivative of the top. Derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of negative t is just negative 1. So we multiply by negative 1. And then we are going to subtract. We keep the top function, which is 1 minus t. And we multiply by the derivative of the bottom. Derivative of e to the 2t. First, it repeats just e to the 2t. But the chain rule says we have to multiply by the derivative of 2t, which is 2. So this is what we have. This is a top right here. And now we move on to the denominator dx dt. So we divide the whole thing by, by the way, Wait, that was the equal sign. dx dt is e to the t. So we just have to do that right here. All right, so this is like a giant fraction, but then of course we can also simplify this, right? And to do so, on the top right here, you can just look at it. This is negative e to the 2t. And then I'm going to just distribute this backwards. And be sure you have the negative sign right here as well. This is 2e to the 2t times negative 1. So we have minus 2e to the 2t. And then we have minus minus becomes a plus 2t times e to the 2t. And this is what we have on the top. And let me put that down altogether right here. This is negative e to the 2t minus 2e to the 2t. We can combine like terms right here. Altogether, that will give us negative 3e to the 2t. And then we add it with 2t e to the 2t. And then this is dividing by e to the 2t squared. So you multiply the exponent, you have e to the 4t. And then the whole thing, this is just on the top, right? The whole thing is still divided by this e to the t. So divided by e to the t, like that. So let's see what we can do. Altogether, I can multiply the top and bottom by e to the 4t, pretty much just like this, right? Anyways, this and that was canceled. You just have to bring this down to a denominator, that's all. You see, you will have negative 3 e to the 2t plus 2t e to the 2t all over e to the t times e to the 4t is e to the 5t. Are we done? No. This is what we can do next. To simplify this again, I'm going to just write it down here. I'm going to break down the fraction. Let me put this down as this over that, which is negative 3 e to the 2t over e to the 5t. And then this is plus 2t e to the 2t over e to the 5t. And then why do I want to do that? Well, if you look at this portion, e to the 2t and e to the 5t, we get to simplify the power. And this is what we'll get. On the top, we still have e to the, we still have the negative 3. But then when the base are the same, we are going to subtract the exponents, right? 2t minus 5t is negative 3t. And you pretty much can put that down as e to the 3t on the bottom, like this. So once again, you can just cancel the power. Combine like terms 2t and 5t, pretty much you get 3t at the end on the bottom, though. Likewise, for this part, we add it with 2t on the top, and then this and that, it's the same thing, like that, 3t. And because they have the same denominator, at the end, you can put them all together, all over e to the 3t, and perhaps you can put this down first, 2t minus 3. This is the second derivative. Okay, that's it.